Welcome to Pinball Mayhem. This is Ed for a quick update on Breakout Cocktail. It's been a little while. That's because I got stuck. Now, this is the wood top that goes underneath the quarter-inch plexiglass top that has the print art printed on it. And what happened is this was badly water damaged. At one point, I believe water came onto that plexi and kind of seeped this way and pretty much deglued this whole side of the cabinet. And if you remember maybe some of my pictures or early videos, it was soft and everything. And I just was stuck on what to do. And that's kind of why the project got stalled, because I got the bottom all done. You can even see there's some of the rotten interior panel that has the stickers I still need to remove or get remade. But I was stuck, so I talked to a friend of mine, Randy, and he has this Abitron epoxy that comes in two forms, liquid and wood, like a putty, and it's for repairing old woodwork, old house restoration. That's where they use it, and I thought that would be perfect. You can see some here I haven't sanded off yet. So I took this whole top, I took it over to him. He laid it on edge, and you wouldn't believe the amount of liquid that liquid epoxy, it's like a water-thin epoxy that he was soaking in. He got around the edge here that was all flaking. And the other thing is he ended up drilling 1/8-inch holes and injecting with a syringe all around here. So I did my orbital sanding today. I'm just gonna throw a little bit of a epoxy in there or putty, not a big deal. And I'll just hit it with a block sander before I paint the top. Right now, to get this moving along, I need to paint the bottom side of this first. Then I'm gonna bolt it to, I gotta drill out the holes and everything. Then I'm gonna bolt it to the frame and paint the top. I'm kind of running short on time and space. What I did is the groove here was really messed up. You can kind of see a little bit of my cut where it double cut there. I just ended up running a T-slot bit with a router, drew it. I set the slot on the other side over here and just ran it around because I know this area was just gonna be full of stuff. So I wanted to do the best I could and give me the best chance. Now, if I have to go in there and file something to make the T-molding hit, that's all right. I went over the whole top, or at least this side, with an 80 grit on my orbital, kind of worn down. Then I went back on 120 and hit the whole top. I hit the bottom up into this wood block, the wood square in the center, just so that I can give it some, ready for paint. I'm gonna paint the bottom first. That's gonna be what I'm gonna get done today still. After I drill out these holes. So where these holes were, we ended up epoxying them in very swollen wood out here. You see here we had to epoxy some in. I'm gonna work and put the T-nuts back into this, drill it out, get the T-nuts in before I paint, and then I'm gonna start painting the bottom before I call it a day today, or the bottom side, and get it bolted on them. Hopefully this project is back on track. The one thing I haven't had a chance to look for is there's this, like, paper tape, like a blackout tape or something. Maybe it's like a gaffer tape, I'm not sure. Seems to be on top of the bolts here and here. It's just like paper tape. It's like really thin. It's just to kind of help keep it smooth. I'm not gonna super worry about that because I'm actually gonna be painting, I think I'm gonna paint the top light gray because there's some damage to the bottom side of the art from the water and the years. So if I do a light gray, that should complement the white background. It's not backlit, so being able to complement that white background that the plexiglass has might reduce the showing of mistakes. And then this area here, you see this rectangle, this is where the paper glue tapes down. So I need to reprint paper labels as well, tape them down, get them lined up. And then in here, there is a smoked piece of plexi in the monitor. So my goal is by New Year's Eve is to have this painted, fully assembled, maybe not the control boxes, but the rubber gasket, all the plastic pieces, the label, and the monitor in, so that I have a little bit more space on my workbench. Right now, this is still blown apart on my workbench. But I want to give you guys an update on how this turned out. It's finally solid enough to paint. And a big thank you to Randy. Brought it over there. We're gonna do it together. He said, this is soaking in so much epoxy. I left it there for a week and picked up the next weekend and he had it all done. So I just got a little bit of work left to do. Other than that, just a little bit of flush epoxy and I'll go over with a block sander real quick. This is ready for paint, which is great. Time to move on to the next stage of the progress. of the project. So thank you for watching, guys. Stay tuned for more quick updates. And quick updates took me a long time to get to. It's going to be a little bit more of a slow process going on, but I am hoping to show you a picture of what it should mostly look like with it all complete. And we'll be making new parts for it next year too. So thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe on Facebook, follow along with what we post there.